God dag, hej och välkomna till 5 spel 5 minuter. 3D Tank Zone is a wireframe tank battle from Dynabyte software. You take the controls of a tank. Your view is from inside the turret. You can look one of four ways and fight with one of two weapons. The weapons change depending on whether the threat is ground or air-based. Although the wireframe graphics of the enemy tanks and the planes are nice enough, the game feels plodding. Particularly with the tank's major firepower, aiming and firing is difficult. The time it takes for your bullet to hit home means the tank you're firing at has got lots of opportunity to get out of the way. Shooting the airplanes out of the sky is less cumbersome, but again, it's not particularly exciting. Frankly, you could probably write your own cursor-controlled shoot-a-plane game in BASIC that's as good, if not better. A game this slow is just boring, so unless you're going to speed this up, either with an emulator or on a Turbo Electron, I'd advise you steer well clear. By the time Around the World in 40 Screens came along, the Repton character was a phenomenon on the Electron. The Repton 3 game provided tools that could be used to completely redesign all of the sprites of the original game. And using these self-same tools, Superior produced this as the first 40 screens of fun. The theme is one of world domination, with Repton touring America, the Arctic, the Orient, the Oceans, and Africa. What this means is the same Repton 3 formula of collecting diamonds and crushing monsters with boulders, but with diamonds replaced with, say, hamburgers in America, and pearls in the ocean. Or in other words, a dazzling display of sprites to assault your senses and tax the old grey matter. The difficulty level is not too high, and my only real quibble with it are the invisible sprites in the oceans, which seem to raise the difficulty level a bit dishonestly. Nonetheless, this is a brilliant game in all respects, limited only by the imagination of the player. In Bonecruncher, you play a dragon, whose job it is to collect skeletons, oil them in a cauldron, make a bar of soap, and then sell that soap to a bunch of steam bath-obsessed monsters. So as far as balmy game scenarios go, it's got it made. The game is an overhead maze game, and it's reminiscent of Repton, but it has far more rules, meaning it's difficult for fans of Repton to get into it. Unlike Repton, you can't just dive in. You really need to study the instructions to understand how to play. For example, each 5 skeletons you collect necessitate a trip to a cauldron. Each trip to a cauldron then means a trip to a staircase. Each staircase is entered from a particular angle. Each angle you enter the staircase at affects the way the white blobs that litter the maze then move. The way these blobs move affects the areas of the maze that you can then reach. If you've digested all of that, then the rules of Fozzie and the random volcano of blobs might actually be enough to break you. The game on the Electron seems quite slow, but considering the strengths of the puzzles, this isn't really a disadvantage. Firetrack is a superb shoot-em-up from the combined talents of Chris Terran and Orlando. You take control of an auto-firing hatch fighter, and your aim is to conquer 4 mining worlds of space junk. You'll fly over a large colony area which smoothly scrolls pixel by pixel while a succession of aliens attack your hatch fighter. Firetrack's aliens follow set patterns, but they always attack in a different order. Each game of Firetrack is therefore different to the previous one, and you can never predict what's going to happen next. You score points by wiping out the nodes, junctions, and computer centers, but you don't actually need to do this. Your ultimate aim is to wipe out the Devil's Rock at the end of the colony. When you reach it, you circle around it again and again, and a few lucky shots should take out its eyes and blow up the world, allowing you to progress to the next one. Firetrack is easily the best shoot-em-up on the Electron by a very long way. House of Horrors is the only known game from a company called Kayess Computer Systems, and the blurb is full of the usual rhetoric about superb graphics and sound. It delivers on no level whatsoever. Written completely in BASIC, the game is one of overhead mazes, 5 of them in fact, each as horrible as each other, and featuring bizarre cutscenes where you climb down towards a cat and get scared by a monster. the gorse you have to avoid simply mill about. In addition, the odd red squares scattered about have to be jumped. Overhead jumping in a maze game? It's always going to be weird, but in House of Horrors they didn't even bother to design a jump animation. Can you tell that I'm jumping these squares? Just looks like I'm running over them to me. On top of all of this, everything runs at a speed comparable to a snail race. House of Horrors was Kayess's only release. Thank God.